I am uploading this video for the nitrogen and its compound in the two part. This is the first part of the video and second part I will upload very soon. So look, what are the members of the nitrogen family? Nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth and new element muscovium is the member or the member of the nitrogen family. Nitrogen family are also called the nicogen. Nicogen means to choke something. Okay, we cannot survive in the surrounding of the nitrogen. Okay, so due to that property, it is also called the nicogen. It can choke our breathing system. Okay, their general electronic configuration is the NS2NP3. Nitrogen and phosphorus are the non-metal. As, arsenic and antimony, these are the metalloid. Bismuth is the metallic in nature. And newly discovered element muscovium is the radioactive in nature. Then nitrogen is sometimes also called mafic air. Why it is called the mafic air? It is called the killer of the life. It is the part of the air. Nitrogen is the part of the air, but we cannot survive in the surrounding of the pure nitrogen gas. So nitrogen, although it is the part of the air, but still it cannot support our living system. So that's why it is called the mafic air, that is the killer of the life. In the atmosphere, it is present 78% by volume. In the earth crust, it is present generally in the two form, NaNO3 Chile saltpeter and KNO3 Indian saltpeter, and it is also present in the living system in the form of the proteins. Okay, phosphorus is mainly present at apatite family. What is the general formula? Ca3PO4 whole twice calcium phosphate dot CaX2. That X can be the fluorine, chlorine and OH. Okay, if it is the chlorine, then what we say? We say it is the chlorapatite. If it is a fluorine, it will say fluorapatite. Okay, it is also present. Calcium phosphate is also present in our bones, in our teeth, and it is also present in the living cell like DNA, RNA. As, Sb and bismuth, they are mainly occurs in the nature as the sulfide. Okay, as we move down the group, atomic radius increases, electronegativity decreases, energy required to lose the first electron always decreases. They have the half-filled electronic configuration. Okay, p3 configuration is the half-filled. So compared to the left and right element, they require the more energy to lose the electron. Because of half-filled electronic configuration, they become the stable. Melting point and boiling point down the group increases, because from the non-metal we are moving toward the metal. But we have one exception. Bismuth has the more melting point and more boiling point as compared to the antimony. The worker, those are working in the surrounding of the phosphorus. Okay, those have a problem, those have a disease called the phosgeo. Phosgeo means it is the decay of the teeth of the bones of the teeth. Okay, nitrogen gas, nitrogen is only present in the gas. Remaining all other P4 onward, they are exist in the form of the P4. Nitrogen is the diatomic, but remaining all other are the polyatomic and they exist in the form of the solid state. Nitrogen cannot show any allotropy. Cross. Nitrogen cannot show any allotropy at the room temperature. Group oxidation number is the -3, +3, and +5. Okay, down the group, stability of the +5 decreases and stability of the +5 increases down the group. Why? It is due to the inert pair effect. +1 to +4 oxidation number of the nitrogen are not very stable. They are prone to the disproportionation, they disproportionate themselves. Okay, similarly, intermediate oxidation number of the phosphorus are not very stable. They again disproportionate themselves to give the compound of the -3 and +5. Nitrogen don't have any d orbital, so they can maximum show the valency up to the 3 and like in the NH4 up to the 4. But all other have the vacant d orbitals. So due to the involvement of the vacant d orbital, they can expand their valency and can show maximum valency up to the 4. Nitrogen form the p pi bond. but no other element from the p pi, their orbital are the sufficiently big, they cannot have the good overlapping to form the p pi bond. Okay, all other element give the single bond. Nitrogen can give the p pi, but all other element they give the single bond, or p pi d pi, they cannot give the p pi. Nitrogen only give the p pi, but nitrogen cannot give the p pi d pi. Nitrogen cannot give the p pi d pi because nitrogen don't have any d orbital, but other like phosphorus and arsenic, by the involvement of the d orbital, they give the p pi d pi bonding, like in the phosphate. In the phosphate, hybridization is the sp3. So this pi bond is obtained by the d of the phosphorus and p of the oxygen. So it is this pi bond is the p pi d pi bond. Okay, bond length of the nitrogen single bond nitrogen is less as compared to the phosphorus single bond phosphorus. The same concept is applicable for the next family. Look how fluorine bond is unstable as compared to the chlorine bond. Similarly, oxygen single bond is unstable as compared to the sulfur bond. Oxygen double bond is more stable than the sulfur double bond. Similarly here, nitrogen double bond nitrogen is more stable than the phosphorus double bond phosphorus, but phosphorus single bond phosphorus is more stable than the nitrogen single bond nitrogen. Why it is so? Because here we have the lone pair, and these lone pair are very near to the each other. Due to the repulsion of these lone pair, this single bond become the unstable. Now hydride of the nitrogen family, PS3, ammonia, phosphine, arsine, okay, cetabine and bismuthane. These are the hydride of the nitrogen family. If we are moving from the NH3 to the BSH3, what are the properties? Bond length increases, bond angle decreases. Here bond angle is the 107, here bond angle is the 91.3 degree. Bond energy decreases, nitrogen hydrogen good overlapping, but bismuth and hydrogen poor overlapping, so their bond energy decreases. Heat of formation increases. This is negative data and here positive data, means it is stable. It releases the energy when it forms, but it absorbs the energy, so these are unstable. If these are unstable, so they can donate the hydrogen very easily. If they can hydrogen very easily, then they are reducing in nature. Basic strength decreases. NH3 is the more basic than the PS3, than the ASH3 and so on. The poisonous character of these hydride down the group always increases. Then oxide, they can give two type of oxide, E2O3 and E2O5. Example like N2O3 and N2O5. Okay, look, oxide of the nitrogen phosphorus are acidic, but arsenic and antimony, they are metalloid, so they give the amphoteric. But bismuth is the metal, and metal oxide are the basic in nature. In addition to the E2O3 and E2O5, they can also give the E2O4. Then next, halide. They can give the halide of the EX3 type or EX5 type. Okay, nitrogen can only give the trihalide because nitrogen don't have the d orbital, so it cannot expand the valency. And nitrogen halide are unstable, they are explosive, except the NF3. NF3 is the stable in nature. All the trihalide mainly covalent, except the BIF3. BIF3 is the ionic, otherwise all the halide are the covalent in nature. Solid PCl5 exists in the form of the PCl6- and PCl4-. It is the sp3 hybridized, okay, octahedral in nature, and it is the tetrahedral in nature, sp3. Solid PVR5 It exists in the form of the PVR4 tetrahedral and bromine minus. Okay, these trihalide the hydrolyze to give the different product, like NCl3 in the water that give the NH3 NHClO. Okay, XCl3 with water give the H3XO3 plus HCl. It is the reaction given by the phosphorus and arsenic. XCl3 plus water give the XOCl plus HCl. This is the reaction given by the antimony and bismuth. With the metal, they show the -3 oxidation number. With the metal, they form the nitride, phosphide, etc. and give the -3 oxidation number, calcium nitride, calcium phosphide. Then the nitrogen, dinitrogen is obtained by the reaction of the ammonium chloride and sodium nitride. It is also obtained by the heating of the ammonium trichromate, also by the heating of the ammonium nitrite, and also by the heating of the NH3 with the CuO. But most important one is the last. Okay, what is that? Pure nitrogen on the small scale, it can be formed by the heating of the barium azide. Barium azide on the heating give the Va and pure N2. Commercial scale, air mainly contain the 20% oxygen and 80% nitrogen. Okay, then boiling point of the O2 is more and boiling point of the nitrogen is less. So if we liquefy the air, then first oxygen will be liquefied, and after the liquefaction of the oxygen, it mainly need the nitrogen in the surrounding. So that's how on the industrial scale, on the large scale, we can have the nitrogen gas. It is the colorless, odorless, non-toxic, tasteless gas, unreactive due to the nitrogen triple bond nitrogen. Look, every metal is surrounded by the nitrogen also and oxygen also, and always concentration of the nitrogen is more. Okay, suppose one iron piece, it is surrounded by the 4 nitrogen molecule and only 1 oxygen molecule, but still it oxidizes. Still it react with the oxygen, not with the nitrogen. Although nitrogen is more, oxygen is less. Why? Because nitrogen has the triple bond, and triple bond require the more energy to break, whereas oxygen has the double bond, and it is very easy to break the oxygen double bond oxygen. So everything undergoes the oxidation, not the nitration, although nitrogen is more in the surrounding. Okay, what is the reason? It is unreactive due to the nitrogen triple bond, which is very stable. But at the high temperature, it react with the metal to give the nitride. Okay, for example, lithium nitride and Mg magnesium nitride, we know these are the metals, those can easily react with the nitrogen. Then reactions of the nitrogen react with the hydrogen in presence of the Fe as a catalyst and molybdenum as a promoter to give the ammonia. Temperature is the 550 and pressure should be the 2 atmosphere. This is the Haber's process. And when the thunderstorm occurs, or suppose we have the very high temperature, then at the high temperature nitrogen and oxygen can react together to give the nitrogen monoxide. Okay, this NO further oxidizes itself to the NO2, and NO2 in the surrounding of the water that give the HNO3. Suppose if rainfall occur with the thunderstorm, then what happens? Due to the thunderstorm, high temperature, they give the reaction, N2 and O2 react together to give the NO. This is called the nitrogen fixation reaction. Due to this nitrogen fixation reaction, we have the NO. NO further oxidized to give the NO2. NO2 with the HNO3 give the acidic rain. Okay, so if thunderstorm occurs with the rainfall, we have the pH less than 7. Okay, one of the important property, nitrogen react with the calcium carbide to give the nitrolium, CaCN twice plus C. It is the nitrolium, it is the fertilizer. Uses of the fertilizer nitrogen, it is used to prepare the inert atmosphere in the industry, like steel industry or anywhere where we require the inert atmosphere. It is a refrigerant, food preservative, chips, Lays, Uncle Chips, these are packed with the nitrogen gas. We don't have the air inside, and it is used for the cryo surgery. ओके, क्रायो सर्जरी मीन्स आई हैव टोल्ड यू, क्रायो मीन्स इंडिकेट द लेस टेम्परेचर. एनीथिंग विल डू एट द लेस टेम्परेचर शुड बिकम इन द क्रायो cryoscopy, the study which we do at the low temperature, cryo tank, the tank which is store the material at the low temperature, cryo engine, the engine which work as the very low temperature, cryo surgery, these are the surgery those are performed at the very low temperature. Okay, so next.